Good afternoon. On behalf of Touchdown Media, I would like to welcome all parents, spellers, and supporters of the 2022 Virtual South Asian Spelling Bee. Before I begin, I would like to introduce to you today's pronouncer and judges. Our pronouncer is Kay Jones, a returning pronouncer. She's a linguist, copy editor, and a published author who speaks four languages and has studied two others. Our judge this afternoon is Olga Vargas. Olga has been a judge and a pronouncer for the South Asian Spelling Bee over the last few years. She's a graduate from York College of Pennsylvania, holding a degree in public relations and speech communications. Linda Tarrant, our second judge this afternoon, was one of the founders of Hexaco Inc., a Texas corporation since 1967, and has served as the president since 1993. The company provides study material for academic competitions as Hexaco Academic. Now, with nearly 40 years of experience supporting spellers nationally, Linda is regarded as a spelling sage amongst advanced spellers. Thank you for being with us today. I'm going to go over the oral round. All spellers who have passed the written round have been assigned a specific speller number to determine their order in the spelling bee. Spellers will be required to be in a well-lit, isolated room for the entire duration of the contest. You're only allowed to have someone help you set up before the competition begins. No other program except WebEx and StreamYard should be open on your system. Please have your headphones, cameras, and microphones on during the entire duration of the oral round. Only if you're on StreamYard can you have your camera off on WebEx. Spellers will be eliminated on a miss and out basis. If the word is misspelled, they are out of the competition. When the judge calls your speller number on StreamYard, the speller will appear on the screen to spell. You must use the format of say it, spell it, and say the word again. When you're spelling the word, you must have your hands clearly visible on the screen and that you must not be holding anything in your hands. If you spell your word correctly, you will return to WebEx for the next round. If you misspell, judges will inform you that the word is incorrect. Exit StreamYard and WebEx. You can then watch the live stream. To be declared regional champion, a speller must spell the word correctly and then spell a final championship word. Both the regional champion and first runner-up will move to the finals. The organizers reserve the right to conduct a tiebreaker and or announce joint winners or declare winners based on the criteria that it deems fit to end the contest in a timely manner. I'm going to go over what the spellers can ask during the oral round. During the oral, the speller is entitled to ask the pronouncer to repeat the word, define the word, use the word in a sentence, provide the part of speech, provide the languages of origin. The speller may not retract a letter once they have begun spelling. I'm now going to go over the appeal protocol. A speller that has the right to dispute the judge's decision and request a hearing before the start of the next round in the contest. Parent spellers are not allowed to approach the judges directly on video call. Parents must submit a written appeal via text to 732-688-9401. Based upon the merit of the claim, I will refer the matter to the judges at the end of that round. In any dispute, the decision of the judges is final. The appeals deadline is before the speller would have received their next word if not eliminated. To minimize disruption, please try to deliver the appeal by the end of the round in which the speller was eliminated. The appeal must provide the speller's name, word in question, and reason the speller should be reinstated. I will now talk about the Save a Seat at the Bee program, which allows you to have more open seats at the finals so the spellers who might have missed their chance at regionals have a second shot at winning it all. The program provides an additional path for spelling champions to experience and compete in the national finals. There are many spellers who have worked diligently but missed their opportunity by one letter. The SASB will open up doors for those bright spellers who always wanted to attend the finals. For more information, you may visit our website. And now, before we start, on behalf of the organizers, Touchdown Media, I would like to acknowledge our sponsors. Without their support, this event would not be possible. Are powered by sponsor Kavan, our academic partner Hexico. And then this initiative is brought to you by the South Asian Engagement Foundation. With that, let's start the oral round of the 2022 Virtual South Asian Spelling Bee. Let me welcome our esteemed pronouncer to take over.
Hi. Your first word is recur.
Recur. May I have the part of speech?
It is a verb.
May I have the definition, please?
To happen, take place, or appear again. Recur.
Recur. Oh, sorry. Recur. Recur. R-E-C-U-R. Recur.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi. Your first word is tinge.
Tinge. May I have the definition, please?
To color with a slight shade or stain. Tint.
Can you repeat the word again?
Tinge.
Tinge. T-I-N-G-E. Tinge.
That is correct. Hello.
Hi. Your first word is opal.
Opal. May I have the definition, please?
Mineral that is a hydrated amorphous silica, softer and less dense than quartz, and typically with definite and often marked iridescent play of colors. Opal.
Am I pronouncing the word correctly? Opal?
Yes.
Okay. Can you please use it in a sentence?
Ellen's pendant was set with a large opal, and the iridescent stone displayed a rainbow of soft colors.
Opal. O-P-A-L. Opal.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is glib.
Definition?
Marked by lack of constraint, stiffness, or formality. Free and easy. Unforced, casual, nonchalant.
Glib. Can you repeat the word?
Glib.
And language of origin?
It's from German.
Glib. G-L-I-B. Glib.
That is correct.
Hello.
Hi. Your first word is abode.
May I have the definition, please?
A home.
Abode. A-B-O-D-E. Abode.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hi.
Your first word is raspy.
Raspy? Can I have all the information, please?
It's an adjective, and the languages of origin, it's English from French from German, and it means resembling the sound made by a rasp, grating or harsh. Raspy.
Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
English from French from German.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's an adjective, and the derivation is English from French from German, and the meaning is resembling the sound made by a rasp, grating or harsh.
Raspy. R-A-S-P-Y. Raspy.
That is correct.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. Your first word is quid.
Quid. Could I have all the information?
It's a noun from Latin. It means a cut or wad of something to be chewed but not swallowed, especially a cut of chewing tobacco. Quid.
Quid. Can you use it in a sentence?
Grandpa put a quid of chewing tobacco in his mouth and climbed on his tractor to mow the field.
Quid. Could you repeat the etymology?
It is from Latin.
Quid. Q-U-I-D, quid.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, your first word is iota.
Iota. Can I have the definition?
An infinitesimal amount, a jot.
Iota. Can I have the language of origin?
Latin from Greek.
Iota. I-O-T-A, iota.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hi. Your first word is poach.
May I have all the information, please?
It's a verb, and it's from English, from French, from Germanic. It means to cook in a liquid kept just below the boiling point. Poach.
May I please have a sentence?
Lois preferred to poach Orange Ruffy, and it only took a short time to cook perfectly in the liquid.
Can you please repeat the word?
Poach.
Poach. P-O-A-C-H. Poach.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hi.
Your first word is gaunt.
Gaunt. Can you give me the definition, please?
Thin and angular, attenuated especially by fasting or suffering. Lank, haggard.
Gaunt. May I have the language of origin, please?
English from Scandinavia.
Okay. Can you use this word in a sentence, please?
After a debilitating illness, Jake had a lean and gaunt appearance to his once robust frame.
Gaunt. 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 G-A-U-N-T. Gaunt.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hello.
Your first word is vixen.
May I have all the information, please?
It's a noun from English, and it means a shrewish, ill-tempered woman. Vixen.
Can you repeat the language of origin?
English.
Repeat the word.
Vixen.
What's the definition?
A shrewish, ill-tempered woman. Vixen.
Vixen. V-I-C-S. U-N, vixen.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-I-X-E-N. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Your first word is verve.
Can I have
The definition, please.
A forceful and lively quality or manner of composition or performance, as of a poem, painting, or musical work. Or it means dash and vivacity.
Can you repeat the word, verve, please?
Verve.
V E R V, verve.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V E R V E.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Your first word is Romeo.
Romeo, can I have the definition?
One given over to a love affair or love making. Romeo.
Romeo, can you give me all the information?
Sure. It's a noun and it's an English fictional character.
Romeo. R. O M E O, Romeo.
That is correct.
Hi.
Hi. Hello. Your first word is addit.
Can I have a definition, please?
A nearly horizontal opening by which a mine is entered, drained, or ventilated. Add it.
Can I have a language of origin?
It's from Latin.
Can you repeat the word?
Add it.
Adept.
Say it again.
Adept.
Add it.
A D E T, adet.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is A D I T, adet. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Your word is lunge.
Can I have all the information?
It's a verb, and it's from French, from Latin. It means to deliver as a kick or thrust suddenly. Lunge.
Lunge. L-U-N-G-E, lunge.
That is correct. All right, and with that, we have concluded round one. We shall move on to round two.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, shoot. Hi.
Hi.
Okay, your first next word is iCar.
iCar?
Yes.
May I have the definition, please?
An ethereal fluid taking the place of blood in the veins of the gods.
What's the word again?
Icar.
Can you repeat the pronunciation?
Icar.
Icar. I-C-H-O-R. Icar.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi. Hello. Talon.
Talon. May I have the definition, please?
An old Celtic harp.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Telin.
Telin. T-E-L-E-N, Telin.
I'm sorry, but that's incorrect. The correct spelling is T-E-L-Y-N.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Kiva.
Kiva. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
What does it mean?
A Pueblo Indian structure used as a ceremonial, council, work, and lounging room for men that is usually round and is at least partly underground with entrance and lighting usually from the roof. And that includes a fireplace, altar space, and sea papu.
Am I pronouncing the word correctly? Kiva?
Yes.
What is the language of origin?
Hopi.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
Used by Pueblo Indians, a round kiva was partially underground, lighted from the roof, and used for important ceremonies.
Kiva. K-H-E-V-A, Kiva.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is K-I-V-A.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. 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 Your word is Tige.
Tige, can I have the all the information?
It's a noun, and the derivation is French from Latin. It means a steel pin in the breech of an early rifle, against which the ball is hammered by the ramrod and expanded to fit the grooves. Tige.
Can you repeat all the information again?
It's a noun. It's from French, from Latin. And it means a steel pin in the breech of an early rifle against which the ball is hammered by the ramrod and expanded to fit the grooves.
Language of origin again, please.
French from Latin.
T-I-G-E.
That is correct.
Hello.
Hi. Quasi.
May I have all the information, please?
It's an adjective from Latin. It means having some resemblance, as in function, effect, or status, to a given thing. Quasi.
Can you use the word in a sentence, please?
The arranger for our band became a quasi composer when he altered the music so much that it was almost his own.
Can you repeat the definition?
Having some resemblance, as in function, effect, or status, to a given thing.
Quasi. Q-U-A-Z-I. Quasi.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is Q-U-A-S-I. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Plié.
Plié. Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun from French. It means a bending of the knees by a ballet dancer with the back held straight.
Can I please have all the information?
It's a noun from French, a bending of the knees by a ballet dancer with the back held straight. Plié.
Can you please repeat the language of origin?
French.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from French, and it means a bending of the knees by a ballet dancer with the back held straight.
Can you please repeat the word?
Plié.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from French, and it means a bending of the knees by a ballet dancer with the back held straight. Plié.
Can you please repeat the language of origin?
It's from French.
Plié, P-L-I-E, plié.
That is correct.
Hello.
Hi. Knish.
Knish, could I have all the information?
It's a noun, and the derivation is Yiddish from Russian. And it means a round or square of rich baking powder dough folded over a savory meat or cheese filling and baked or fried. Knish.
Knish, am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Okay. Knish. Could you repeat the etymology?
Yiddish from Russian.
Knish. Can you use it in a sentence?
Our Jewish friend from Poland teasingly referred to our flauta as a Mexican knish.
Okay. Knish. K-N-I-S-H. Knish.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Pahua.
Pahua. Can I have the language of origin?
Marquesan.
Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun from Marquesan. It means a giant clam, a clam found on the coral reefs of the Indian and Pacific Oceans that sometimes weighs more than 500 pounds.
Pahua. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Marquesan.
Okay. Pahua. P-A-H-U-A. Pahua.
That is correct.
A seal. A seal. Oh, you're on mute.
May I please have all the information?
Yes. It's a noun, and the derivation is Latin from Greek plus German from Greek. A seal. It means a marine flatworm of the Acoela order.
Can I please have it in a sentence?
An acoel is not parasitic, but they reproduce easily, and in large numbers, these flatworms can damage corals.
Acoel. A-S-E-A-L. Acoel.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is A-C-O-E-L. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Éclat.
a claw. May I have the language of origin, please?
French, from Latin, from imitative.
Okay. May I have the definition, please?
Dazzling effect, brilliance.
Okay. A claw. Can you give me all of the information, please?
It's a noun, and it's from French, from Latin, from imitative, and it means dazzling effect, brilliance, éclat.
Okay, éclat. Can you repeat the language of origin again, please?
French, from Latin, from imitative.
Okay, éclat. E C L A T, a claw.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Your word is gnat.
Gnat. Can you give me all the information?
It's a noun. It's from English. And it refers to any of various small two-winged flies. Gnat.
Gnat. K.
Gnat.
Gnat. K N A T. Gnat.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is G N A T. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Your word is snavel.
Can I please have all the information?
It's a verb. It's of unknown origin. It means to get hold of by fair means or foul, to rustle up. Snavel.
Snavel. S N A V E L, snavel.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is S N A V V L E. Thank you. All right, and with that, we have concluded round two. We will be moving on to round three.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Caduceus.
Caduceus. Can I have the part of speech, please?
It's a noun.
May I have the definition, please?
An insignia consisting of or bearing a caduceus, such as one used to symbolize a physician.
Caduceus. Caduceus. C A D U C E U S. Caduceus.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Gallinazo.
Okay. Gallinazo. All the information.
It's an adjective, and it's from Spanish, from Latin. It means over relating to an ancient culture of the Viru Valley in northern Peru, characterized especially by negative painted pottery, irrigation, textiles, and limited metallurgy.
Okay, gallinazo. G-A-L-L-I-N-A-Z-O. Gallinazo? That is correct.
Alençon.
Alençon, can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun and it's a French geographical name. It refers to a delicate, originally handmade needlepoint lace characterized by the cordonnet outlining the floral designs on a fine mesh background. A lensan.
Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
It's a French geographical name.
Can you please repeat all the information?
Mm-hmm. It's a noun and it's a French geographical name. And it means a delicate, originally handmade needlepoint lace characterized by the cordonnet outlining the floral designs on a fine mesh background.
A lensan.
A lensan.
Am I saying it correctly? A lensan?
Yes.
A lensan. A L E N C O N. A lensan.
That's correct.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Ibsenian.
Ibsenian. Could I have all the information?
It's an adjective and it's from the name of a Norwegian poet, dramatist. It means of, relating to, or having the characteristics of the playwright Ibsen or his plays. Ibsenian.
Could you use it in a sentence, please?
The play's Ibsenian thesis propounded the Scandinavian idea that truth is dangerous to man's precarious happiness.
Ibsenian. Ibsenian, am I pronouncing it correctly?
Yes, Ibsenian.
Could you repeat the etymology?
It's from the name of a Norwegian poet, dramatist.
Can you repeat the definition?
Of, relating to, or having the characteristics of the playwright Ibsen or his plays.
Ibsenian. Ibsenian. I-B-S-E-N. E-A-N, Ibsenian.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is I-B-S-E-N-I-A-N. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Hui.
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 Hui. Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun from English. It means consisting of, containing, or resembling hui. Huiish.
Is it pronounced huihi?
Hui.
Hui. Can I have all the information again, please?
It's a noun from English, and it means consisting of, containing, or resembling hui. Hui-ish.
Hui. H-U-A-I. Hui.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is W-H-E-Y-E-Y. Hui.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Aubergine.
Aubergine.
Aubergine, yes, aubergine.
Aubergine. May I have the definition, please?
Eggplant.
Okay, aubergine. Can I have the language of origin, please?
French, from Catalan, from Arabic, from Persian.
Okay. Aubergine. Can you use this word in the sentence, please?
Visiting Provence, Nancy had never tasted eggplant, but she found several specialty dishes featuring aubergine that were amazing.
Aubergine. Okay, aubergine. A U B E R G I N E. Aubergine.
That is correct.
Thank you.
And with that, we have concluded round three. We are now moving into round four, but before we do so, I want to acknowledge the fact that we are now at our top four spellers. So congratulations, spellers, for making it to the top four.
Good job, congratulations.
And now we will move on to round three. I mean, round four, sorry.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Bruxism.
Bruxism. May I have the definition, please?
The habit of unconsciously gritting or grinding the teeth, especially in situations of stress or during sleep. Bruxism.
Thank you. May I have the part of speech, please?
It's a noun.
Bruxism. Bruxism. B R U X I S M. Bruxism.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Porphyry.
Porphyry, can I have all the information?
It's a noun. The derivation is English from French, from Italian, from Latin, from Greek. And it means an Egyptian rock consisting of feldspar crystals embedded in a compact dark red or purple ground mass, much used by the ancient Romans. Porphyry.
Okay. Can you repeat the word again?
Porphyry.
All info, all information.
It's a noun, and the derivation is English from French, from Italian, from Latin, from Greek. And it means an Egyptian rock consisting of feldspar crystals embedded in a compact dark red or purple ground mass, much used by the ancient Romans.
Porphyry? Can you say it again? Porphyry.
Porphyry.
Can you just repeat the word again?
Porphyry.
Definition.
An Egyptian rock consisting of feldspar crystals embedded in a compact dark red or purple ground mass, much used by the ancient Romans. Let us see both hands, by the way.
Both hands. Oh, it's there, but. Porphyry.
Can we see both your hands?
It's there.
Oh.
Okay. Porphyry. P. O. R. P-H-Y-R-Y.
That is correct.
Jojoba.
Jojoba, can I have all the information, please?
It is a noun from American Spanish, and it means a shrub or small tree of southwestern North America with edible seeds that contain a valuable oil. Jojoba.
Jojoba. Can you please repeat the language of origin?
American Spanish.
Okay, can you repeat all the information, please?
It's a noun from American Spanish, and it means a shrub or small tree of southwestern North America with edible seeds that contain a valuable oil.
Can you please repeat the language of origin?
American Spanish.
Can you repeat the word?
Jojoba.
Can I please have the definition again?
A shrub or small tree of southwestern North America with edible seeds that contain a valuable oil.
Jojoba. J-O-J-O-B-A. Jojoba.
That is correct.
Yarfa.
Yarfa. May I have the language of origin, please?
Scandinavian.
Okay. Yarfa. May I have the definition, please?
Peat bog.
Can you repeat that?
Peat bog.
Can I have it in a sentence, please?
A Scandinavian will dry peat from a yarfa and use it for fuel, and this practice is centuries old.
Okay. Can you give me all of the information, please?
It's a noun, a Scandinavian, and it refers to peat bog.
Okay. Can I have the part of speech again, please?
It's a noun.
Okay. Can you pronounce
Yarfa.
The word? Okay. Yarfa.
Yarfa.
Yarfa. Okay, Yarfa. Y-A-R-F-A, Yarfa.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is Y-A-R-P-H-A. Thank you. All right, so with that, we have concluded round four. We will be moving on to round five, but before we do so, I want to acknowledge the fact that we have made it to our top three spellers. So congratulations, guys, for making it to the top three.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We will now be moving on to round five.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay. Your word is kaike.
Kaike, may I have the language, please?
Spanish or Portuguese.
Thank you. May I have the definition, please?
Any of this small, stocky, often brightly colored parrots native to northeastern South America.
Kaike?
Yes, kaike.
Okay, thank you. Kaike. C A I Q U E. Kaike.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Ayatollah.
Ayatollah is, okay, Ayatollah. Definition and language of origin.
The language of origin is Arabic, and it means a religious leader among Shiite Muslims, used as a title of respect, especially for one who is not an imam.
Ayatollah. A-Y-A-T-O-L-L-A-H. Ayatollah.
That's correct.
Atana.
Atana. Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun, and it is from Russian, from an Alaskan geographical name. And it refers to an Athapascan people of the Copper River Valley in southeastern Alaska. Atana.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun. It's from Russian, from an Alaskan geographical name. And it refers to an Athapascan people of the Copper River Valley in southeastern Alaska.
Can you please repeat the definition?
An Athapascan people of the Copper River Valley in southeastern Alaska.
Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
Russian, from an Alaskan geographical name.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun, and it's from Russian, from an Alaskan geographical name, and refers to an Athabascan people of the Copper River Valley in southeastern Alaska.
Atana. Can you repeat the word one more time, please?
Atana.
Atana. A-H-T-E-N-A. Atana.
That is correct. And with that, we have concluded round 5. That was our first perfect round in the competition. So we will now move on to round 6.
Hi.
Hello.
Krakowiak.
Krakowiak. May I have the language of origin?
It's an eponym from Polish.
Krakowiak?
Krakowiak, yes.
Krakowiak. K-R-A-K-O. W-I-A-K, Krakowiak.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Plaque.
Plaque, can I have all the information?
It is an adjective. And it's from French. And it means of a seal affixed directly to the face of a document rather than pendant from a ribbon or other fastener. Plaque.
Plaque. Can I have the part of speech?
It's an adjective.
Okay, plaque. All information. Can I have all the information, please?
It's an adjective from French, and it refers to a seal. It means affixed directly to the face of a document rather than pendant from a ribbon or other fastener. Plaque.
Plaque. P-L-A. Q-U-E, Pake.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Myelitis.
Myelitis. Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun, and the derivation is Latin from Greek. It means inflammation of the spinal cord or of the bone marrow. Myelitis.
Myelitis. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Latin from Greek.
Can you please repeat all the information?
Mm-hmm. It's a noun, and it's from Latin from Greek, and it means an inflammation of the spinal cord or of the bone marrow. Myelitis.
What's the language of origin again?
Latin from Greek.
Can you repeat the definition?
Inflammation of the spinal cord or of the bone marrow.
And what was the part of speech again?
A noun.
Can you repeat all the information, please?
It's a noun, and the derivation is Latin from Greek, and it means inflammation of the spinal cord or of the bone marrow.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Myelitis.
Myelitis. M-Y-E-L-I-T-I-S. Myelitis.
That is correct. All right, and with that, we have concluded round six, another perfect round. We will be taking a short break before moving on to round seven.
When you're standing there, you have that one moment where you're like, oh my God, I worked so hard to get here.
Heart stopping when they're just staring at you with like blank eyes.
And I'm finally here.
And then they just tell you if it's right or wrong. And if it's right, oh my gosh, I'm so happy.
Successful. S-U-C.
I cannot get over how much this has blown up in the past 6 years.
Every year we added a city since 2008. We've received a tremendous response. We were trying to create a platform that everybody can take advantage of. We wanted to create something that would actually contribute towards the overall development of the entire family and engage that audience.
It's like really fun, actually. It's like a good hobby.
I just want to learn new words,
and I wanted to like be on TV, so I...
And that's how we came up with it, and then we spoke to some of our wonderful sponsors that help us build this platform.
We have education, experience, entertainment, all in one.
It's going to be cool when I go on TV.
It's very important to us because our entertainment is all about family values. And kind of, you know, format and concept like Spelling Bee fits very, very nicely with that.
Because it's due to the kids, it has a much wider appeal to all walks of different communities all around.
It's mind-boggling when you look at what the South Asian Spelling Bee has done for the South Asian children. Every year it becomes stronger.
The event is promoted heavily across media platforms like national TV, print, online, and grassroots to create a buzz and attract participation.
Insurance giant MetLife, along with Sony TV, sponsored the event that was held over the summer, and we asked, can your child spell?
If I win, it'd probably go
towards my college funds.
College.
For college?
College.
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 A lot of toys.
College.
For my education.
College.
My education.
For a new car.
College.
For my education.
For college.
College.
As my parents would say, use it for your college, but I would use it for a game console or a video game.
It's been 5 years for MetLife to keep returning as the title sponsor of the Spelling Bee, and it's been a wonderful experience to be part of the lives of these families. Our MetLife agents are really part of the community, so they are always there for parents to be able to prepare their children for their higher education.
I feel like our support of this Spelling Bee, the South Asian Spelling Bee specifically, has even elevated and given more visibility to the community to compete in other venues.
I like spelling because like spelling is like, I like, it's fun like to learn spellings, definitions, language of origin.
It improves my knowledge of words and I can spell better.
I've been studying hard.
I can't wait for my chance.
I am really proud to be here.
Show everybody that an 11-year-old girl can do about anything.
If you really look at it, while preparing for a spelling bee, kids are not just looking at the word and memorizing it. They're understanding where it comes from, how it is pronounced, what it means, how it can be used. Basically preparing them for life. Like one of the top spellers told us, that the stuff she learns at a spelling bee, she can use it anywhere.
They get to be with their own community, see what other kids do. They learn to focus, they learn to be dedicated towards doing something, towards working towards a goal.
Now the whole family gets involved more closely into this process of learning.
The rest of her life is going to help her. If whether she wins, she doesn't win, it doesn't matter. As long as she experiences this whole thing, it makes her confident.
When I see her confidence, I want to support her.
Nushatel?
Yes.
Is this a kind of cheese?
Yes.
Oh, good. Nushatel.
I think this allows them to do that is sort of have this sort of training ground, you know, where they can cut their teeth and train.
It was a very great experience, you know. Every year I came here and every year I enjoyed myself.
And like one newspaper put it, if you excel at the South Asian Spelling Bee, then you have a really good chance at Scripps.
See, the role reversal now. So earlier we kind of followed the national format and now we are producing the national champions.
So we provide that platform that they can come and compete with the best of the best.
Socoptera. Socoptera.
Socoptera.
Perfect.
Socoptera. P S O C O P T E R A.
That is correct.
Yeah, you can be the greatest. You can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find.
I think it's a great educational experience for the kid.
The words are great, but I think the learning process is even greater.
This is a great opportunity for him.
We wanted to create something that would actually contribute towards the overall development of the entire family and engage that audience.
But at least she's getting that platform. I appreciate MetLife for sponsoring and wish all them good luck.
The South Asian Spelling Bee specifically has even elevated and given more visibility to community to compete in other venues.
This is our way of showing the community that we care. You know, it's a great opportunity for the kids to come together. And finally, the winner gets $10,000 check from MetLife.
Spelling Bee started off as a concept which we thought we would bring the South Asian families together and we could do something on the same lines of the scripts. But eventually we realized that we were doing much better.
Go the distance, you can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try. Do it for your country, do it for your name.
Impressed with the fact that there's a kid from Ghana who found his way to enter the regional competition, won it, and is now at the finals all the way from Africa.
Yes, they contacted us and said, we want to come. I said, well, you know, Ghana's a little far away. They said, yes, no, we'll fly. I think they believe in their speller's ability to hone this craft, and they're, as parents, giving him every opportunity there is for him to succeed.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try.
So not immune, but
this is my first time at the South Asian Spelling Bee Nationals. I'd want to be the word perfection because it's perfect and perfection is awesome.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions. Standing in the Hall of Fame. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And the world's gonna know your name. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
G-I-S-T.
Mom, is that right?
I don't know. I don't.
Zwetschenwasser. I think it's Zwetschenwasser. I guess it's the last word in that list.
So more than a competition, I think it's a place to have fun and just learn new things.
It's a very fun experience.
I think it opens their mind.
That gives them a path for learning.
Well, I think Spelling Bee is a very good opportunity for them to learn how to set a goal.
They have learned a lot during the Spelling Bee process. It taught them discipline.
Persevere.
Self-learning.
And understand that hard work is what is required for success.
It will be useful towards other subjects like math, science, all the way through college and work.
Everything he learned, it helps him in the life in future.
We've been watching this show for the last several years.
Yeah, it's one of the most prestigious Spelling Bee competition for the South Asians, and we wanted to be a part of it.
And he's been excited watching it. So wanted to have him experience the stigma, the performances of every kid, how different levels of kids come in.
I think it's a great family activity, I can say, right?
And we enjoy this. It's like a kind of like outing for us.
I learned a lot of new words with him, and I think as a part of the learning, I had fun too.
We just want to have fun and enjoy that day.
And so we are all helping her with her journey on Spelling Bee.
Correct.
Thank you.
Correct.
All right, we are now starting off on round 7.
Hi.
Hello.
Sifflaminate.
Can you repeat that?
Sifflaminate.
Sifflaminate, may I have the definition?
To obstruct or impede.
Sifflaminate. Sufflaminate, sufflaminate.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Smaragdin.
Smaragdin, all information. Can I please have all of the information?
Mm-hmm. It's an adjective. It's from Latin, and it means of or relating to emerald yellowish green in color.
Smaragdin. S-M-A-R-A-G-D-I-N-E. Smaragdin.
That is correct.
Lipofuscin.
Lipofuscin, can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun, and the derivation is Latin from Greek plus Latin. It means a usually yellowish-brown, pigmented, insoluble granule that contains protein and lipid and accumulates in cells as of the heart, liver, or brain as part of the normal aging process, and sometimes in association with diseased states.
Lipofuscin, can you repeat the word, please?
Lipofuscin.
Lipofuscin. L-I-P-O-F-U-S-C-I-N. Lipofuscin.
That is correct. All right, and that concludes round 7, another perfect round. We will move on to round 8.
Hi.
Hello.
Vernissage.
May I have the definition?
Varnishing day, the opening day of an art exhibition. Vernissage.
May I have the language?
French, from Latin, from a Greek geographical name.
Can you repeat the word?
Vernissage.
Vernissage. V E R N I S S A G E. Vernissage.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Camelopardalis.
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 Camelopardalis. Okay. I just want to make sure, is it pronounced Camelopardalis?
Camelopardalis. Pardalis.
Pardalis.
Camelopardalis. Pardalis.
Pardalis. Okay. Definition?
A northern constellation that is visible between the constellations of Cassiopeia and Ursa Major, and that is represented by the figure of a giraffe. Camelopardalis.
Camelopardalis. Can I have the language of origin?
Latin from Greek.
Camelopardalis. Can you repeat all the information, please?
It's a noun, and it's from Latin, from Greek, and it means a northern constellation that is visible between the constellations of Cassiopeia and Ursa Major, and that is represented by the figure of a giraffe.
Okay. Camelopardalis, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Camelopardalis. Can you repeat the word one more time?
Camelopardalis.
Camelopardalis. C-A-M-E-L-O-P-A-R-D-A-L-U-S. Camelopardalis.
I'm sorry, but that is incorrect. The correct spelling is C-A-M-E-L-O-P-A-R-D-A-L-I-S.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. boost your feet on.
Can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun, and it's from Greek. And it means the writing of alternate lines in opposite directions. One line from left to right, and the next from right to left.
Wait, utrophedon?
No. Boustrophedon.
Boustrophedon. Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
Greek.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from Greek, and it means the writing of alternate lines in opposite directions. One line from left to right, and the next from right to left. Boustrophedon.
Boustrophedon. Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
Greek.
Can you repeat all the information?
It's a noun from Greek. It means the writing of alternate lines in opposite directions. One line from left to right, and the next from right to left.
Boustrophedon. Am I saying it correctly?
Yes. Boustrophedon.
Boustrophedon.
Yes.
Can I start over, please?
Yes.
Boustrophedon. B. O U S T R O P H E D O N, boustrophedon.
That is correct. All right. And with that, we have concluded round 8. Before we move on to round 9, I just want to acknowledge that we are now in our top 2 spellers. So, congratulations, spellers. You Thank have you. Both made Thank it you. To the finals. As we move on now, we will just be moving on with placement. That's the only thing you're competing for, but you've both made it to the finals.
Hi.
Hi.
Ignimbrite.
Ignimbrite, can you repeat the pronunciation, please?
Ignimbrite.
Ignimbrite. Okay. Ignimbrite.
Yes.
May I have the definition, please? Thank you.
A hard rock formed by solidification of chiefly fine deposits of volcanic ash.
Ignimbrite.
Ignimbrite.
Ignimbrite. Ignimbrite. I G N I M B R I T E. Ignimbrite.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Calamondin.
Calamondin. Can I have all the information, please?
It is a noun from Tagalog. It means a small hybrid citrus tree native to the Philippines and cultivated as an ornamental.
Calamondin, can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from Tagalog. It means a small hybrid citrus tree native to the Philippines and cultivated as an ornamental.
Calamondin, C-A-L-A-M-O-N-D-I-N, Calamondin.
That is correct. That concludes round 9. We will now be moving on to round 10.
Hi.
Hello. Before we start, I also want to state that if you both spell perfectly for the next 3 rounds, you will be declared co-champions.
Okay, thank you.
Hold on 1 second. I think we will need to take a break for a short time before we start.
Mm-hmm.
G-I-S-T.
Mom, is that right?
I don't know. I don't.
Zwetschenwasser. I think it's Zwetschenwasser. I guess it's the last word in that list.
So more than a competition, I think it's a place to have fun and just learn new things.
It's a very fun experience.
I think it opens their mind.
That gives them a path for learning.
Oh, I think Spelling Bee is a very good opportunity for them to learn how to set a goal.
They have learned a lot during the Spelling Bee process. It taught them discipline.
Persevere.
Self-learning.
And understand that hard work is what is required for success.
It'll be useful towards other subjects like math, science, all the way through college and work.
Everything he learns, it helps him in the life in future.
We've been watching this show for last several years.
Yeah, it's one of the most prestigious Spelling Bee competition for the South Asians, and we wanted to be a part of it.
And he's been excited watching it. So wanted to have him experience the stigma, the performances of every kid, how different levels of kids come in.
I think it's a great family activity, I can say, right?
And we enjoy this. It's like a kind of like outing for us.
I did. I learned a lot of new words with him, and I think as a part of the learning, I had fun too.
We just want to have fun and, enjoy that day.
And so we are all helping her with her journey on Spelling Bee.
छोटी छोटी भूख और करना है कुछ को तो क्लैप अलोंग क्लैप 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 अलोंग थोड़ी थोड़ी मैजिक और बहुत सारा फन तो क्लैप अलोंग क्लैप 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 अलोंग
कवान मलबार रोटी के साथ क्लैप अलोंग एक्स्ट्रा फ्लफी क्रिस्पी और टेस्टी के लिए क्लैप अलोंग कवान ट्रूली फ्रेंडलिशियस
So for me, spelling is not really just a learning experience, it's also something you enjoy, something you exhibit later into the future, something you have to embrace while you're there. My favorite word is caoutchouc. Just the complexity of that word and other words in French, it just really interests me. When I'm not studying, I like to read, I like to play cricket. I like to bike. I like to do karate.
Hey! 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 Hey!
I like to hang out with my friends and family. Right now I have a really big interest in astronomy, so I'm planning to become like an aeronautical engineer. So after I started learning spelling, I've become a completely changed person. My personality's changed. I've gained more knowledge, gained more confidence, and I'm able to face more things that I haven't been able to face before.
The moment when I'm on stage, spelling the word on the mic, that's my most favorite part. As soon as you finish spelling the word, you have that feeling of adrenaline rushing through your body to see if you're correct or not.
My favorite word is cwm, and it's spelled C-W-M. My favorite etymologies are Welsh and Gaelic. I find the way you spell the words a little complicated. When I'm not studying, I like playing Indian music on the keyboard. I also like playing the flute in my school band. I also know Taekwondo. I'm not really sure what I want to be, but now I'm interested in astronomy, and I hope I discover what dark matter is made out of in the future. So for me, home is a place with 100% comfort and love.
Very happy. happy that this platform has been able to deliver to the community something that they can be proud of. A spelling bee is not just about spelling, it's about teaching these students their life skills.
Man, it was quite an experience for me to be a finalist. It was so exciting for me and my family to go down to New Jersey to compete against some of the best spellers in the country.
It brings out the talent in children. It is a great family program for Sony, and we believe in family entertainment. That has been our philosophy from day one.
A spelling bee was a very Americanized concept that the South Asians took to heart.
It is all about families, because you talk about Asian kids, you talk about anything to do with education, it's a family package.
It's been an amazing run for us.
We've been together for the last 8 years. It's been a fantastic partnership.
For me, it was so exciting to see other kids who love the same thing I did and just wanted to go out there and show the entire world what they got.
When we started it and we saw what the response that we got, it was amazing just to see 4,000 participants coming in from 12 cities.
This platform is now known as the gold standard in spelling bees, and we give them the opportunity to come and compete with the best of the best.
We have seen the runners-up of South Asian Spelling Bee go and win the Scripps.
Some of the top competitors at Scripps happen to come to the MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee as well. We're competing together with some of the best spellers.
And we've been very fortunate over the last 8 years to have a lot of support from people that believe in what we are doing. MetLife has been a consistent supporter that underwrites the entire cost of this. Sony Entertainment Television broadcasts this in 120 countries, which gives the spellers the thrill of being on television.
Put these kids in front of the camera and all of a sudden something happens to them. And that's the most amazing thing which I love to watch on the television.
Kavan Paranta believes in family values and bringing the family together, and they've been with us for the last few years. We want to thank these people along with all our media partners that help us spread the word.
The MetLife Spelling Bee, it's a great opportunity. And when you just go out there and you go out there to spell, it's just the most exciting thing. So don't be nervous, don't be scared, go out there and just have fun.
Studying for a bee helps me overall because I can use it like in all of my classes, like English, social studies, math, and even science. But I also like it because I can like stump my friends with these hard words. I like reading, I like baking sometimes, I like playing sports like tennis, basketball, and I even like swimming. I like playing the piano. I love the thrill of achieving a goal because it always motivates you to do something even better, even higher. It's one of my favorites, and like it's probably well known from Mary Poppins, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Or I like any animal, to be honest, so I guess even a veterinarian would work for me. So I guess I just really want to help them out. My family literally means the world because let it be like here, it could be even like the Arctic, as long as they're there, I'm fine.
When I was in second grade, I gained interest in spelling words, and then I just started doing spelling bees. My hardest favorite word that I know is Reisstoffel. Some of the words are fun, and the definitions help me know more about medicine. When I grow up, I want to be a doctor or a surgeon. Some of the roots of the words could help me know medical conditions. Music helps calm me, and sometimes if I'm upset, it makes me happy. I've liked reading since I was in first grade. Sometimes if you like a book a lot, then you're like taken into a magical world where the book's taking place. My family helps me study for the bees by giving me a list, and then they quiz me on the words later. Home to me is where my family is and everyone belongs.
I got into spelling because I started reading at a very young age, and that developed my passion for spelling. I actually love competing in BEES because you can meet new people, they're fun, then you can have a new experience each time. My favorite word is ipo-ipo. It's a type of leguminous shrub. Home is where my family is and where my friends are. I feel happy and secured at home. When I grow up, I want to be a cardiovascular surgeon or a chemist and a scientist because I want to help save people's lives. And I see a lot of family members who are doctors and they've inspired me to be a doctor.
That we are celebrating a 9-year anniversary is testimony to the fact that people have accepted this platform, people are taking advantage of this platform.
It's grown immensely. I mean, the popularity, the activity, the buzz around the events.
We see the Spelling Bee as a unique platform for us to reach out to the community.
And we are able to connect with the entire family unit who comes out and participates as a whole.
All our networks still are very family-based entertainment products that we have. And we wanted to give back to the community that we have been a part of for the last 9 years through Spelling Bee.
I know education is a leading involvement and we want to be part of that journey.
With the Indian community, it's about education, it's about family values.
Our advisors love becoming involved. They ask us year over year if we're going to participate and network and meet the families that are a part of the community, and they love being a part of it.
These past 9 years have been amazing. From a production standpoint, every year it grows and it grows and it grows.
We've seen year after year you have the kids winning at the national scripts. In fact, they've been dominating.
And we are kind of in a league of our own, I would like to say. I think that all of that goes into showing what our community can do if we give them a good professional platform.
When you look at the kids and when you see them under the pressure, I think we are more under pressure than they are.
Really exciting to see the passion, the fervor.
They're as cool as a cucumber.
It's so exciting. It's almost like a sporting event.
Best of all, that every year we see a new crop of spellers who want to do their best.
I've made lasting friendships with people that I've met in South Asia ever since I was 8 years old. And those are some of the people who are my closest friends right now.
They do such an amazing job. It is amazing to see these kids out there.
So I say salvation was a big life-changing experience for me.
It's this idea of children who suddenly discover the spark in them and just take off. And that's what y'all are doing. So thank you for doing that.
Thank you. You'll probably see them as the presidents or the CEOs of large corporations.
Because of you, we are all here.
But in order for those spellers to have the platform, the support of the sponsors year after year after year is key.
And this is not for us just to hard sell, but also for them to understand that commercial company can also reach out to the community.
Britannia is actually very excited to partner with South Asian Spelling Bee.
And we look forward to many more years to come.
But we wish the South Asian Spelling Bee another great year.
But I want to congratulate Rahul, Touchdown Media. What an amazing moment it is for India in New York.
We are very proud to be associated with this concept. All this hard work of 9 years of building the concept in America is now going beyond.
We've announced that we are going to be in Ghana, which is going to be our 13th center today.
And we're looking forward to adding more countries and wish you all the very best.
And it's an open platform where parents can simply go to the website and register their child to participate.
Hello, everyone. All right, we are back on and we will be starting off with round number 10, spelling number one.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Okay.
Knock-a-lost. Knock-a-lost.
Knock-a-lost?
Knock-a-lost.
Knock-a-lost. May I have the definition?
A dark cheese made from whole or partly skimmed milk and spiced with cumin, caraway, or cloves, or all.
Knock-a-lost. N-O-K-K-E-L-O-S-T. Knock-a-lost.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Hayari.
Hayari, can I have all the information, please?
It's a noun from a British Guiana name, and it is a fish poison. Hayari.
Hayari. Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from a British Guiana name, and it is a fish poison.
Can you please repeat the definition?
Fish poison.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun, and it's from a British Guiana name. And it is a fish poison.
Hayari. H A I A R I. Hayari.
That is correct. All right, that concludes round 10. Another perfect round. We will now move on to round 11.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Elvenik.
Alphanic?
Yes. Alphanic.
May I have the definition, please? Sorry, yeah.
Of relating to or having the characteristics of an alphan wave, which is a transverse electromagnetic wave that propagates along the lines of force in a magnetized plasma.
Thank you. Alphanic. A-L-F. V-E-N-I-C, alphanic.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Orogia.
Can you repeat that, please?
Orogia.
Orogia.
Orogia. Orogia. Yes, orogia.
Can I have the definition, please?
A small genus of South American vines, sometimes cultivated in greenhouses for their white or pink flowers.
Orogia. Can I have all the information, please?
Mm-hmm. It's a noun from the name of a Portuguese statesman. And it's a small genus of South American vines, sometimes cultivated in greenhouses for their white or pink flowers.
Does it come from Greek or meaning mountain?
I don't have that kind of information.
Oh, okay. Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun from a Portuguese statesman, and it refers to a small genus of South American vines, sometimes cultivated in greenhouses for their white or pink flowers. Orogia.
Can you repeat the language of origin again?
It's from the name of a Portuguese statesman.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun, and it's from the name of a Portuguese statesman. And it means a small genus of South American vines, sometimes cultivated in greenhouses for their white or pink flowers.
Orogia.
Aragia.
Aragia.
Aragia. Uh-huh.
Can I start over, please?
Yes. Yeah. Sorry.
Aragia. A R A U J I A. Aragia.
That is correct. All right, that concludes round 11. We will now be moving on to round 12. If both spellers spell correctly in this round, they will be declared co-champions.
Hello.
Hi.
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 Cytherean.
Cytherean. May I have the part of speech?
It's a noun.
May I have the definition?
A votary of Aphrodite.
Cytherean. Cytherean. C Y T H E R E A N. Cytherean.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Exerg.
Exerg. Can I have the definition, please?
A space on a coin, token, or medal, usually on the reverse, below the central part of the design, sometimes marked off from it by a line, and often containing the date. Exerg.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
French, from Latin, from Greek.
Can you please repeat all the information?
It's a noun, and the derivation is French, from Latin, from Greek. A space on a coin, token, or medal, usually on the reverse, below the central part of the design, sometimes marked off from it by a line, and often containing the date.
Exer. E-X-E-R. G-U-E. Excerpt.
That is correct. All right, congratulations, spellers. You are now co-champions.
Congratulations to our New Jersey co-champions. This is the second regional where we've had co-champions. Tarini Nandakumar and Yash Scheller, congratulations and welcome to the finals. How ironic that our New Jersey regionals have spellers, champions from Texas. And Texas and Yash, where are you from?
Missouri.
Missouri. So congratulations. Great job. And thank you everyone for watching. We will see you tomorrow at the Fremont Regionals. And then I'm now going to be off the screen so that Maitri can take a nice picture of our co-champions. Wonderful. Tarini, I hear you're logged in from India, right?
Yeah.
What time is it there?
It's actually 1:13 here.
Good job. This is dedication. Wonderful. Congratulations. I'm sure you're going to get a lot of pampering tomorrow. Congratulations, Yash, and we will see you at the finals.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much for tuning in. We will see you tomorrow at the Fremont Regionals. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.